They often say that the most exciting investment thesis is usually doom and gloom accompanied by a potential investment opportunity. So, for example, the gold bugs will often talk about how the U.S. economy is ready to collapse, and that if you invest in gold now, then you're going to make a mint while everybody else suffers. Now, that may very well be the case, but the takeaway here is that people seem to enjoy benefiting from the misfortune of others, or at the very least, they enjoy investment opportunities that nobody else sees, because presumably there's a lot more alpha there. Investors have been doing that for a very long time. So today we're going to talk about one of those. It's called spiking neural network technology, or SNAP. And it's important to note that today we're just going to talk about the facts. So there will be people that come around and don't like what we're saying, but we're simply stating facts taken directly from the company.
That's just an interesting fact.
So SNAP technology, 5,000 times faster than current neural computers, using just 1/1,000th of the power. It was first announced in 2015, and at that time, the company was in discussion with Fortune 500 firms. They were hiring to accelerate development and on track with their milestones. So they expected to deliver by November 23rd, 2017, a SNAP 64 chip and what's called a Brainchip development kit. So this company's name is Brainchip, and it trades on the Australian Stock Exchange. So in 2016, the CEO said that it would be a very important year for Brainchip, during which they would expect to license their technology to a number of companies.
Sure. Yeah. Okay.
That's great. And this chart here, this shows a line going upwards and to the right. Usually, you know, that's a good thing to see, unless, of course, it's costs. And they said that this significant technical milestone that's depicted in this release alongside this chart would help progress licensing discussions with various Fortune 500 companies. So this all sounds very promising. They even talked about their marketing strategy, which is to establish partnerships. You can see here two partners, one for what appears to be computer vision, the other for robotics. And then, of course, they plan to announce, to be announced partners for these other areas, embedded drones, smartphones, and then future partners for areas such as big data. Well, then later on in 2016, they announced an acquisition. They acquired this firm called Spikenet. It's a French revenue-producing AI company. And the first thing to note here is the small amount of cash they put down, 530,000 euros. And they said in this press release that the acquisition of Spikenet fast tracks brain chip development timeline. And here's highlights in the transaction. Pay very close attention to language. So they have the potential now to create the world's most technically advanced, biologically inspired computer vision products with an immediate, forget waiting, man, immediate path to commercialization for Brainchip SNAP technology, expected to give the company an immediate source of revenue, recurring income, and a ready customer base at an attractive price of around $2.2 million. Well, for anybody that needs that put into perspective, I think my first job in finance, that's what our MD made in a year. So this isn't a very big acquisition. It's rather small. And after a month goes by, then we're told that they're rolling out some game protection technology at a major Las Vegas casino. They successfully completed phase one of a trial, and a second casino will be added in the next month, followed by a rollout to more of this group's casinos. This rollout will provide an immediate and growing revenue stream for Brainchip. There's a huge market opportunity here, somewhere in the range of $4.5 billion. That sounds great, right? Well, a few more months roll by, and then another clarification press release. It's hard to keep track of all the press releases that are coming out from this company, but they talk about how the company anticipates additional commercial agreements in casino gaming, civil surveillance, and visual inspection. And they say, at this juncture, we have commercial engagements, trials, and meaningful discussions with large casino operators, airports, schools, etc. Pay attention to the verbiage here if you haven't already. Companies don't typically talk about meaningful discussions. I had a meaningful discussion last night with a lady of the night at a Dubai bar. That didn't mean that a deal was closed. So meaningful discussions and $5 won't get you a cup of coffee at Starbucks anymore. So when we look at what they actually realized in 2016, so this is about after all that talk about the revenue from casinos and whatnot, They cleared $232,000. That's miserable. And actually cleared less. And we're going to talk about that in a second because they needed to restate this number, perhaps because that French AI acquisition wasn't what it said on the tin and they discovered some skeletons in the closet. So moving on to 2017, they talk about, I like this press release here, so it's about an exclusive license of their technology, and it says that it further solidifies, notice the language there, BrainChip's position as a leader in the field of neural networking and artificial intelligence technology and solutions. Wow, right? That sounds really cool.
Very cool.
Few months go by, another press release regarding their casino endeavors. So they now have a field trial at a leading casino in Las Vegas, Nevada, that's following the successful deployment of the game outcome solution at the Mohegan Sun Casino. So in my past life, I managed the regional deployment for a multinational firm of Salesforce to a global enterprise software sales team, and I trained them how to use it. At no time did we tell our investors how many trials we had going. The same holds true for Palantir's AIP workshops. These are vanity metrics that mean very little. And of course, cheerleaders and stock promoters are the only people paying attention to this stuff. When we look at BrainChip's press release here, we see they talk about, again, we're still in 2017, shipping their first BrainChip accelerator card to a major European automobile manufacturer. ADAS and autonomous vehicle applications sound pretty juicy, right? So let's see what sort of revenues they recognize for 2017. Again, putting all the press releases aside, at the very least, the casino stuff should be, along with that acquisition, bringing in a good chunk of change right now. Nope. It isn't. So in 2017, they realized $270,000, and they had to restate, as I said before, they restated those 2016 revenues. So whatever they acquired wasn't what it said. So let's take an intermission real quick and talk about what we've seen so far, which is a lot of promise and very little delivery. So for our perspective, we've been doing this for a very long time, and there are just obvious red flags everywhere. But that, of course, was back in 2017, and this is 2024, so that's given them at least 6 years to pull this together. So for the sake of brevity, we're going to try and move things along a little bit faster. Now, before we do that, I wanted to point to this Roth conference presentation they gave and just highlight two bullet points here. They talk about having, this is in 2018, high-quality global customer base across multiple industry segments. That implies that people are paying you meaningful amounts of money. They say here, public market investors have few opportunities to invest in pure-play AI companies. Really? Well, that's actually true, but if they were reading Nanalyze, and several years before that, they would have read one of the first pieces that we wrote about NVIDIA in this piece, The Artificial Intelligence Stock That Rocked Wall Street. And then 3 years on, if they would have read 4 years on, a piece we wrote on how BrainChip stock should be avoided, then retail investors would have fared fairly well. And if you want to sign up to our newsletter where we distribute the research that we produce, which isn't just the videos on this YouTube channel, we have over 2,400 research pieces that we've written, then just click this link here. So a few months later, they came out with this other deck, and you see here the chart on the right showing their chips outperformance against NVIDIA's solutions. Now, whether or not that's true doesn't matter. NVIDIA has been selling a ton of AI hardware, and this firm hasn't. And I liked this slide in the deck. It talks about OEM and end user sales, a large sales pipeline, revenue growth, and profitability. These are great terms to throw around, but they mean very little unless you're showing results. Here's a look at some more 2018 press releases. I had a hard time keeping track of all of them. I just threw a few down here. Now, indeed, they are showing some revenue growth here. But again, that's what my old MD made in half a year. So they haven't even cleared $1 million in 2018. Now, let's just jump forward 5 years. And what do we have here? So at the end of last year, they realized a whopping $1.67 million, and they burned through $17 million. Now, there was a slight glimmer of hope, and that was back in 2022, when they actually saw $5 million in revenues. That's good. That's on the way towards the $10 million in revenues that we expect to see from a company before we'll even take a look at them, right? And why are we looking at BrainChip? We'll tell you in a second. But this here shows that the sale of product and license transferred at a point in time is the majority of those revenues. In other words, they're not recurring, and we shouldn't be surprised to see them go away in 2023. Now, when it comes to compensation, they're certainly making sure their talent leading the ship is getting compensated appropriately. So despite the fact they only brought in $1.6 million in revenues in 2021, $4 million in compensation went out to key management personnel, and that doubled the following year. So what we see with BrainChip stock is over the past decade, their incredible technology solutions have brought in almost exactly $10 million in revenues over 10 years. We expect that in a single year before we even consider looking at a company. Now, outstanding shares during that time have nearly tripled, so investors have been diluted all to hell, and they've had losses somewhere around the range of $130 million. So why did we cover this firm to begin with? Well, we have no dog in the BrainChip race, and I guarantee you there will be people accusing us of being short in the comment section. We don't short stocks ever.
Never, never, never.
Our BrainChip video, the last one we did, was one of our most popular, and it was also downvoted more than any other video. And there are a lot of people out there who don't like the facts, man. So premium subscribers, the people who pay our bills, they tell us that they enjoy the occasional roast of a company with execution that's complete and utter shite.
Watch your profanity.
So they also enjoy watching the cheerleaders come around and get torn to shreds. So have at it, gentlemen. Now, the key takeaways here: do not invest in companies unless they have meaningful revenues, and learn to spot the signs. Nonstop press releases, meaningless language being used, customers that don't provide revenues, trickle revenues over time, inconsistent revenues, constantly releasing new and exciting products, and the list goes on. So if you want to see what a real AI hardware company looks like, take a look at NVIDIA, and you might ask yourself, well, is it too rich right now? Well, we did this recent piece to show that maybe, in fact, that's not true. So before you watch this video, please make sure to sign up to our free newsletter and like this video. Thanks so much for taking the time to watch this today.